and welcome to onlinegroomingschool.com. My name is Yvonne, and what we're going to show you today is how to groom a Scottie, a Scottish Terrier. Here is Dundee. So say hello, Dundee. Now, Dundee is a mix, but he's got probably 90% more Scottie in him than anything else. And we're going to say hello and say hi. And what we've done with Scottie, we'll show you what we've done on the other side, but what I'd like to do first is introduce you to the tools that we're going to be using to show you how to groom a Scottie. Following the simple rules of the Sam Cole, I want to show you what we use as a guide. Is the All Breed Dog Grooming Guide by Sam Cole. Okay, really great book. And I wanted to show you just how many easy steps there are, how easy it is to follow his grooming guide. It shows you how to bathe, what to use in the bathing process. It also indicates the lines, the numbers. Number two here tells you how to clean the ear. Okay, so just follow the number guide. Also, it shows you the lines of where you're going to do the clipping and what blades to use. In this example, you could either use 5, 7 and a half to do the body. Okay, today we're going to be using a 7 finishing blade. Also, on this side, it shows you how the head should look like. And the front and back view of this Scottish Terrier. And then how he should look after he's completely groomed. Okay? So, great recommendation. You should really, this is a great, it's like a Bible for groomers. So, what we're going to be using today are two slicker brushes. I always like to have two handy, a small one and a larger one. We are going to be using straight scissors, curved scissors, and thinning shears come in really handy when it comes to the terrier breed.
Now on the scissors, how long are these guys?
This is 8 1/2. These are 7 1/2. It really, really depends what you feel comfortable with. If you have a larger breed, they have to cover more ground, then you're going to go down the 7 1/2, but I'm comfortable with the 8 1/2. So
8 1/2 straights and
7 1/2 curves.
7 1/2 curves, okay.
But you could have 7 1/2 straights, it doesn't matter.
And then I see you have two slicker brushes. Why is that?
Just if I want to get into the small areas, more sensitive areas around the eyes, I can brush, around the beard with this one. Larger areas. So
okay, good deal.
And then what we have here is two number 10 blades and two number 7 finishing blades, and those are the blades we're going to be using today. Obviously, we need a clipper. We have the Anda Super 2-speed clipper.
So you have two number 10 blades. Is there a reason why you need two blades?
Well, you just don't want to clip a dog if your blade is hot. So it's always handy to have more than one of the same blade. So if my blade gets hot, I'll just switch blades and put the cool blade on the clipper. And then obviously, you could also use a coolant on your blade to cool it down. And we explained that in the pet hygiene CD series. We also have a wall coreless clipper. I always have this handy, not necessary for this clip, but it's nice to have something really quiet and for small areas. This particular clipper has an ascending blade length, so all the way this way it's a 9, and all the way this way it's a 40. But it's not made for big jobs, only for small areas. Okay, mm-hmm. And again, you have your greyhound comb, which is your fluffing comb. All right.
The greyhound comb, the fluffing.
Yeah, it's just a fluffing comb. It's also called the fluffing comb, but the correct word for it is greyhound comb. Okay? All right, so we're going to get started. I'm going to set some things here. Now, it's a good idea not to have your scissors and clippers sitting on the table with a dog. You're taking a risk of them shoving off the table and then breaking, but for the purpose of teaching here, we want to kind of have everything handy and show you what's available for clipping the dog. So we're going to attach Dundee here to what's called the groomer's helper. And the groomer's helper is a grooming loop or grooming restraint, all right? And it has a little ring here that you can attach to this bracket, okay? So if you see this here, I can unattach him or attach him again. What that does, it helps to control the dog. He can't turn around and get you or something, startles him. It's just easier for you to be able to have a dog that's sitting still than not. I want to show you, we did do the one side of Dundee here. Okay. And basically, the Scottish Terrier has a skirt. Now, ideally, Scotties do have, and I'm gonna use the word Scottie a lot just for the purpose of shortening it, is that their skirt is usually almost touching the ground. He just happens to have a short skirt. Most of your pet owners are not gonna have their breeds in, you know, what you would see in a show. But, you know, you just work with what you have. Again, the skirt will usually go from here. Big tubular legs. All we did was just clean up the bottom of the feet, make them kind of round, all right? And the same would apply to the back. All right? So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and show you how to get that look on this side. All right? So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and use a number 7 blade. Excuse me here for a second. And I should be more careful of using the term 7 or 4 or 5. If you don't, you have to understand that most clips are done by finishing blades and they are followed by a letter after the number. So if you don't use a letter after the number, you're assuming you're using a skip tooth. Again, we explained that in the pet hygiene instructional video, but for this purpose, understand we're using a finishing blade. So we're gonna start with a 7 finishing blade. We're gonna start about the neck. We'll finish on that. We're gonna really go up to the base of the skull here, but for right now, I'm just gonna start here. Clipping with the grain, meaning we're clipping with in the direction that the hair grows.
Now that's the 7 blade you're using here, right?
Correct.
7 finishing.
7 finishing blades. So for the purpose that I want to make sure you understand, we're not using a skip tooth. If you're using a skip tooth, you really have to specify that. Now, where do we stop on this line? Here's the flank. It's a piece of skin that dogs have right here. Okay, so what we do is we put our finger here and tuck up. And where we're gonna start the line is where it tucks up. So where it, you know, if it came up higher, we'd start higher, but here it is, so that's gonna be our line, our guideline.
Mm-hmm.
Notice as I get closer to that line, I'm no longer just stopping. I'm flicking the clipper. So there's my guideline. Now I've got something to work with. Going all the way to the front of the chest. Now I'm going to loosen or take them off this handle here so I can get to the front of the neck. Obviously you want it to match both sides, so if you have to, you know, go a little lower to match the other side, that's okay. I'm going to look to see if we have a pretty good line. Looks like I have to go just down a little bit further. Nobody's going to come to your dog and pick a ruler and, you know, and see if you're exactly where you're supposed to be. You just want to get there as close as possible. All right, so there's our first line. If you happen to have bought our complete series and you've watched the Schnauzer clip, you can see that this is kind of almost the same, except that the Schnauzer clip, the line goes to the back of the hawk here, right? With the Scottie, we're going to leave it. We're going straight across.
Okay? Straight across and nothing with the legs?
Nothing with the legs. It stays
full.
Wow,
it just stays full.
Yeah. So, you know.
That's an easy clip.
Yeah. You know, a lot of clips like that. So sometimes it's just a matter of just a little bit of a line variance.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now what I want to do is, you know how I said we want to make look a little, how the thinning shears come real handy, is this thinning shears do, it makes it even look even more natural. What I'm doing here is clipping every other hair is what the thinning shear is doing. And allowing the coat to lay flatter without actually taking off length. And you see how that's kind of laid a little bit flatter now.
Mm-hmm.
I know, Dundee, these lights are hot. So continue to do that all the way around to create a more seamless, nice skirt. Like it naturally grew that way, like it just grows short on the top and longer on the sides down to the bottom. I'm glad that doesn't happen, because then we'd be out, groomers would be out of business. We'd have a job. Okay, so see how that's just kind of natural falling? Okay, I'm gonna do the same thing in the front here.
So you kind of hold his head up with your other hand and...
Yeah, you just, you know, when you're a groomer, you have to learn how to stretch and bend and work around the pet. Now, if the pet is interested in something happening behind him and he's really adamant about it, turn your table around, let him look. It's going to make your job a whole lot easier. See how that's kind of falling a little bit nicer now? It was kind of puffy here in the beginning. Not taking off a whole lot of hair, just thinning it out a little bit. We cut. So we just continue thinning out the skirt until we feel that we've gotten a nice flat look where it's not like sticking out. So I think I'm satisfied with that. We're going to move on to next, and I'm going to get in front of you. For a second here. You want to go ahead. Remember I said we just want to kind of leave, we want big tubular legs. We'd like to have a longer skirt. That's not the case today, but so you know that most of the time, mostly they have longer skirts. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my curves my curves and just go ahead and start clipping around the paw here just to clean it up. Going all the way around. Now if you have to pick up the paw, you could do that. It's not against the rules. You want to get the back in here a little bit. Now terriers, Scottish terriers have two coats. They have a, you know, cottony undercoat. So the bottom, the undercoat can get pretty matted. So you still need to brush. Owner still needs to brush and make sure they keep the coat in good shape. It also produces nice oils in the skin that helps the coat look healthier. Why the outer coat is a kind of a harsh wiry coat, and that doesn't mat up as easily as the undercoat. Okay, kind of just leaving it kind of big and messy almost.
Just like a tube, huh?
Just like a tube.
Tubular, messy, looking nice.
You don't want a terrier to look too clean. Not too many straight lines. Okay, same thing with the skirt here. I'm just kind of let it, because what we want to do is we want to let that skirt grow. Now, see what he just did? I've seen groomers allow their dogs to sit while they're being trimmed on the back. What that happens is you start to lose the lines. It's like you going to get your hair cut and you're laying down. That doesn't work. So I'm just getting the tips. I'm just trying to make sure just to, if there's any split ends that So they grow out healthy. I'm going to repeat the same thing in the front. Dundee. You a crocodile, Dundee?
That's his name, is Dundee.
Dundee. He loves being groomed. Mom says she doesn't like to, he doesn't like to be brushed, but he didn't give me any problems. That's okay. As soon as I say that, he's pulling, huh? Again, if he had like massive overgrowth, I'd be clipping more, but he doesn't have a whole lot. I'm just cleaning off anything that sticks out like a sore thumb. Front of you here, and see how normally the skirt would go all the way down here. Looks from here, it looks like it's all has grown all the way down. All right. Now I left the tail alone because I wanted to show you what we're going to do with the tail. So we're going to move on from the tail to the head in just a little bit. Okay. Thing about the tail is, you're going to use the same blade that you used on the body on the tail, but only on the front, on the top, excuse me, not on the bottom. I'm going to show you what we're going to do to the bottom. We go all the way to the tip. Slightly on the sides, not all the way. But all the way to the tip, just on the top. Then you take tail, and brush it out a little bit. Oh, you can sit for that part. And you just trim it.
With the straight or the curves?
You do the straights or the curves.
I see.
Leaving it longer at the base and then going narrow into the tip. See, ideally he would have it out to here. Doesn't have the hair growth out here. So it's more narrow at the tip and leaving it longer as you go, like a feather. Okay? So that's basically what a Scottie's tail should be done like. Okay? Mm-hmm. Simple. No rocket science here. Alright, so now we're going to move on to the head. My favorite part is you're going to see a really big difference when we start working there. All right. Now I want you to see what we've done to the other side already. You see that we've already shaved the skull, the sides, and part of the ear, and then created the V-type eyebrow, and then thinned out the
Can I see the V-type eyebrow again?
This thing? Peace sign?
Like a peace sign, huh?
So straight up and down to the nose here, and to the corner of the eye on this side.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Now, most Scotties have more of a direct, erect ear. Okay, again, Dundee is mixed. And what we did is we just made a couple of changes for them. So don't get caught up in, oh my gosh, it's not laying the way it's supposed to, or he doesn't have the hair that he should. Just work with it. On a Scottie, a little bit of hair is left here. It's called a tuft, T-U-F-T, on a Scottie ear. Okay? Or if the client wants it, we can just go ahead and shave that. But I just wanted to show you how you would leave that little bit of trees here in the front of the ear.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? The other thing you do is you would also leave hair back here. But because he's got wavy hair, so I can show you the effect. Because most Scotties would have more wiry hair, not this wavy hair, yes. But I want to show you how it would look clean. So we're going to move on to the other side. I'm going to show you how we got that effect.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so on the head, we're going to use a number 10. 10 and above are not finishing blades, so they don't have a number following, so it's okay to use, say, just 10. I'm going to go just a little bit. The eye is right here. This is the eye socket. This is this bone right here, if you look up here, where your eyebrow is, that little bone, that's what we're looking for right here, the ball. Mm-hmm. And we just want to go just a little bit behind that as a starting point. The sockets right here is going to start up a little bit more. All the way to the base of the skull. Don't go down to the neck, just to the base of the skull. You can feel right here. It's the base of the skull. Alright. I'm going to trim his ears. Again, only because the kind of hair he has. But if this was a full bred Scottie, the only thing we would trim with a number 10 is about 1/4 down the ear. On both sides, meaning not all the way down, just about 1/4 down the ear, and then do the same on the inside. Okay, it's the only difference that if you got a full bred Scottie, you may make sure you do that. All right. Now, because we didn't go all the way up to the neck here, I'm going to switch back to my 7. And finish the neck up just really quick here so that we can move over with the head. Whenever you're switching blades, forgot to do this part, make sure you don't get distracted. Like right now I'm working with a 7 finishing blade on the neck. And let's say somebody came in and then I switched to a 10 or something, and somebody came in and talked to me and I forgot that I had the 10 on the clipper, then I start clipping the neck with a 10, and that would be good, but just a word of caution. Remember in the pet hygiene DVD, there's lots of danger points around the ear, so be careful. Slow down. I'm going to show you what we're going to do with that ear if he was a full-bred, purebred Scottie. Now I'm going to take the tips here, use my fingers as a protective barrier not to clip the ear leather. I'd rather clip myself than the dog, and I've done it. I've got my grooming scars, war scars. And most of them were not inflicted by another dog, it was just me. So what we did, you can see that, is just cleaned up the edge. Okay? Next, what you would do, take your thinning shears, pull the ear down like this, and take all of this with your thinning shears on the edges, and just start cleaning it up a little bit. Just to give it a more natural look, I bent the ear in half. Being careful with thinning shears, they can still cause damage, so don't think that it can't cut skin. Good boy, Dundee. Being so patient. Alright. So there's that furriness there. Again, just cleaning up a little bit back here. Saw some things out of place there. All right, there's those trees I was telling you about. Okay, could use a little bit more thinning here. Like little protective trees in front of the ear canal. Okay, baby. All right, those little tufts. Alright, so now we're going to move on to the beard. Okay, so here we are moving on to the beard and the eyebrows. I'm just brushing out a little bit. I'm going to look for those small slicker brush. Using my finger to cover the eye. I don't want to accidentally scratch the cornea there. Alright, so what I like to do is brush up the eyebrows and use my thinning shears just to clean up the inside of the eye. Let's see, I'm going to move up here. Now see, Dundee here has an eye irritation
Client has asked us to keep the eyebrows short. I'll go ahead and clip them short afterwards, but I'm gonna go ahead and clean this up. Whenever you have a dog that has any kind of infection or eye irritation, make sure you disinfect your tools before using them on the next dog. I'm just cleaning that up. All right. Oh my goodness, I can see. Mommy says he likes to play in the dirt and stuff, so that's probably why he's got eye stuff going on. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and create the eyebrows. I'm gonna grab my curves now. And in the middle here, between the two eyes, this has to be clipped out. I'm going to use our curves because that's how naturally the eye and the nose goes. All right. All right, Dundee. Gotta sit still for this. Okay. We're going to go in the middle here. Just take a little bit and snip. Okay. Hang on. See how we just create a little passageway there? And now that I've got that, I left that for the purpose of being able to show you before how it's supposed to look on one side. Now it gives me the opportunity just to thin this out a little bit here because it's supposed to look very straight and very, not bushy, just serious eyebrows. I'm just gonna clean it up a little bit just to match it up where I want. Now there's that peace sign we talked about earlier. Take your scissor, go to the tip, and go to the edge of the eye here. Natty's got what they call visors.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Cool, huh?
That's how it's done, huh? For a scottie eyebrows, huh?
Now, again, if you saw the Schnauzer video, if you bought the whole series, you'd see that this is very similar. I'm going to clean up the head a little bit more. It's okay to go back, because as you start doing things, you see you might miss something. I'm just cleaning up, make sure my line here where my eyebrow starts and my head starts are well defined. All right. Now we're getting close. Okay, now this line right here has to appear someone like this. Right. Yeah, there's those thinning shears. One groomer once told me he's really good, apparently. You can do a whole scottie head, or tear your head for that matter, with thinning shears alone. I believe it now, I didn't believe it then. Okay.
So you want to do like a backslash on a keyboard, huh?
Yeah, if you have that, it's find something that relates, that you understand. That's a good example. I talked about that undercoat, that the undercoat gets matted up. We're almost done. Still not satisfied with that. Now it's starting to
So you just keep thinning until you're satisfied with the look then, huh?
Yeah, you just want to have that nice,
slick
look. Now on the front, just messy look.
You don't do anything to the front?
No. I mean, unless the client wants the beard to be a little bit longer. I mean, it shouldn't be dragging on the floor, but it should be close to this length.
Dundee, look at the camera. Good boy.
Let's clean up one more area.
Hi, Dundee.
We're just about done.
Here you go.
One more thing, Dundee, and we're done, okay? Kind of go a little bit higher here on the neck. Again, just you see something out of place, go back and finish it up. You know, do that head tilting thing. Walk away a little bit and look at the dog from a distance. Because sometimes it's hard to see what you're missing. Like out here, I can see something here already. I'll show you. It's hard to see what you're missing when you're up close sometimes. Want to make sure. Everything is looking good. Let me just give it a once over here. Let me look. Just going to walk away from it and look a little bit. Hi, dude. What's up? Hey, you look great. Okay. Now, one thing you can do as a finishing touch is a lot of your pet stores and stuff like that will have what's called leave-on conditioner. It's a pet silk. It works great on terriers. It's basically like an oily substance, but a little bit goes a long way. And what that does is just gives it a little bit of luster, a little bit of control.
Does it smell?
It smells great. I can do this before I go to the grocery store after a long day of grooming. Nobody will ever know I'm a dog groomer.
I can smell the aroma now.
Can you smell it? Smells good, huh?
What kind of bottle is that? Can you show us so people can get a
The bottle
feel
is basically a bottle that I've refilled, but it's called Pet Silk. You can get it from Pet Edge, Ryan's Pet Supply, even your local Pet Smarts or Petco's, and just ask for Pet Silk, and that's the name of the leave-on conditioner. So there you go. There's Dundee. Dundee, say goodbye to everybody.
Bye, Dundee. Bye-bye.
Just like any other video, make sure you view it at least, three times. Look at the instructions and obviously look at Sam Cole's grooming guide, and you'll be a pro at this before you know it. So thanks a lot, and we'll see you on the next one.
Well, Yvonne, thank you so much. And Mr. Dundee,
bye-bye.
Here you are. See you later, big guy. Thank you so much.